Thomas.
My boy! My beautiful boy! My God, you did it, Bolek!
I still have to examine him more thoroughly.
But look!
Ding, dong, 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 ding.
God gave me the wisdom to instruct Bolek to find a cure. And through his hands, he released us from this terrible disease. We have been tested, but we are stronger now.
Thank God for Bolek. Praise be to God.
When can others get the treatment?
I am happy to forward any new cases of the disease to Bolek for treatment. We no longer live in fear of the disease's approach.
But my son, he smells. He sweats and he sleeps. In the morning, I had this big bear snoring through the ceiling. His hands had twice the size of mine. And his poor mother, running to get him food and work, he shall not. What about our work, our business? The business I should hand over to him, he is no longer fit. I would clout him if he didn't tear over me, if he didn't frighten me so much.
My daughter, she disappears into the night. She paints her face and dresses in such an unsavory way that I think the sweet child I knew is dead. She no longer talks to me, but regards me with such a disdain that it sends shivers through me. I lock her door, but she is devious. This creature takes pleasure in tormenting me.
How many of you have been hiding the infected? By God, Bolek, a mission! It's greater than we thought!
But, Mayor Wenzel, I haven't had enough time to monitor Thomas.
Please, you're our only hope!
Help us!
Forgive us, God!
Please help us, Bolek. Before she was a changeling...
I just wanted my daughter back!
I wrapped her up like she was a little baby. But then by morning, she was going all crazy! Please help us, Bolek!
The Lord stands with you, Bolek. And gives you hope.
Children.
Yes, these are our children.
And who knows what's right for them?
What's best for them?
Than a parent who loves them.
Yes, a parent who knows them.
A parent who knows them well, and dare I say, knows them better than themselves. Because these are our children.
Yes, these are our children. Yes, these are our...
A success! I knew the rats, that their temperament became more agreeable after the procedure. But I didn't know the human brain could be so contained. It's as if the subjects have swallowed a happy pill. Life is easy. They help their parents. They're happy to spend time with them again. They do not want the things that they cannot have. They're not controlled by wild emotions. Read that last bit back to me. They help their parents. They're happy to spend time with them again. They do not long because they cannot have. They are more than controlled by wild emotion. Read that last bit back to me. New page. Mr. Karch reported it. His son spent all yesterday chopping wood, one after the other. He said he'd never seen work so hard before without complaint. Mrs. Sawtow said that her daughter now sits with her all day, darning socks, contented. Village life has returned to a time we'd all forgotten. But they are vacant. After treatment, they're docile. There is a certain mental dullness, yes. Do you think it's important we record that? Of what mental agility do they need to herd reindeer or catch fish? The important thing is that their madness has all but gone. I found this. Where did you get that? It has a note inside. Come on, give that to me. Look, she writes about healing from diseases. Don't listen. I'm a mad woman. Now won't you listen to me? Is this what you want to be? Some mad woman travelling around the countryside with a potion? Why won't you let me make up my own mind? She's lucky they didn't string her up in the village square.
Lucky? I wouldn't call her lucky.
You don't speak to me this way.
Am I at her?
I don't.
Is that what you're afraid of?
Valetta? Valetta, are you okay? What's that?
Did you eat it?
I don't know. We need to test you.
No!
Melodra, please.
I don't want to!
Melodra, come back!
Stay still, I'm gonna stay in my home!
You hurt me.
Bolek, are you down there? Bolek? Ah, there you are.
Ah, Mayor Wenzel, to what do I owe this?
Don't stand on ceremony. We're friends, aren't we? How do you like your new workroom?
Yes, sir. I've bought new supplies. I'm working on my book.
That's good news. Good news indeed. Look, I'm no man of science, as you may know. And you know how we all appreciate what you've achieved. You are an utmost valued member of this village, Bolek.
Mayor Wenzel, please, I'm afraid I don't have time.
I understand you're busy, Bolek, forgive me. I'll be as to the point as I could possibly be.
Yes?
Well, it's just that I've had people visit me, parents of those you've treated, and whilst they are eternally grateful for you carrying their children in such a succinct fashion, they do have some concerns.
What concerns?
Well, it's just that their children seem to be a little... There's something missing.
Mayor Wenzel, I'm afraid I don't have time for puzzles.
They're not quite there. Mr. Kushka's boy went to the storehouse with no boots on. His feet turned black. He might lose his toes.
I fail to see.
And Thomas, Previn took him hunting. He said it was like the boy had never held a bow and arrow in his life. He practically poisoned himself with his own dart.
That boy always was an idiot.
And Miss Sotov asked her daughter to give the floor a good scrubbing. She practically wore a hole, scrubbing through the same spot, people all day long, coming to me with their fears.
All I hear is good things.
They keep coming to me with their fears.
As I remember before, they were scared of their children eating them. Would they rather go back to that?
I'm sure they wouldn't. But perhaps you could speak to the villagers. I'll show them that your treatment is sound. Perhaps in time their children will return to normality.
Yes, sir, I can do that.
Bolek, I feel there is something I should share with you. It is to remain a secret that is very important.
Yes, sir.
Well, Laszlo, he presented with the symptoms. They worsened.
Yes, I know. You cast him out.
Well, no.
No?
I kept him in my barn, tied up, of course, until the disease left his system.
You told everyone on the strictest terms that they must cast their children out.
I know. I live with this every day. But haven't you noticed? The few that return, once the monster left his system, the infected that return, they are strong, capable young men and women now.
What are you saying?
I'm saying, Laszlo, look at him. I can't leave him alone. I'm afraid he might hurt himself. You know, I have strange dreams sometimes that I'm out in the woods. I'm licking sap off of a tree. I'm running. Flashes sometimes that I'm caught under a wolf. And I'm sticking my finger in its eye.
You've been under a lot of stress.
Don't ever dream things like that. What was that?
It was just a rat. I've trapped it under the cupboard.
You should get rid of those rats, Bolek.
I will.
Maybe I've said too much. This will remain between us.
Of course.
I will put notices up, and you can address villagers tomorrow morning. In times of crisis, we need people like you, Bolek. You always keep your head. Your children are no longer the fevering creatures that once tormented you. The monster which locked their eyes and put them in a state you no longer recognize. What you see now are your children in a free and happy state. They are no longer troubled, out of control. We must thank God that this curse upon their heads has been lifted.
Thank you, God.
Bolek, sir, please. I ask my son every morning what he wants. I do not know.
My daughter stares out the window. I ask her what she's doing.
Her mother is gone. Aren't you grateful that she has such an obedient child?
The spark is gone. It's gone.
Yes, I know that you are all eager for you. Please, let us not let our senses. The procedure they have is highly
invasive,
and as such, we must give them time to fully recoup. Isn't that right, Bolek?
Please, Bolek, my son, he must recoup. He must, please!
Calm yourself! Anyone would think we were made. Are your children alive? Are they fit and well? I did not look possessed. Then we must give thanks to this man. Kissing his boots, not pestering with such nonsense. When the farmer plants his seeds, he's expected to pop up the next day.
No.
And as such, we must care for them. And in time, they will return to normality. Isn't that right, Bolek?
Yes! All normal behaviors should.
There. There we have it. Nothing to be concerned about. Now, we shall return to work and we shall no longer speak of it.
This is our destiny. Looking for us. Fairy tales are magic. She became quite obsessed with it. Believe she was beginning to have problems. I grew up in the town to the bloodlust. You don't know. Suddenly, she wasn't just people thought she was one. She refused to bow to them. Which I begged. Never did. She held her hands, body, enchanted. I can't do this. I can't do this. Let me out! I'm treating you. Out! Out! I do command and conjure thee. Thou art a true demon. Let me out! I summon thee here from this child. I do summon thee by the power of the prison me by the dark abyss.
Out!
Bolek the scholar and Melena. Perfect little Melena. Well, well, well.
This isn't what it looks like.
Let's have a look at her then. Do excuse me. I've had some of my husband's ale. Somehow it helped.
Get away from her!
My daughter didn't form a bath quite like yours, but she had the same redness in her eyes.
This is just a precaution. She's a
healer!
I am treating her.
Yes, absolutely. I never thought I'd see the day. Your wife, incantation. Don't be embarrassed, Bolek. When it's our children, we'll be look at me, offering up my beloved by you.
I give my.
Why would you offer Melena the same treatment? Girl. Too good for it, is she?
She's going to
my daughter is gone!
I'll look at her. I'll see what I can do. Some way I can make previous connections. I can work.
It's too late now. I took my girl, I walked her to the edge of the wood, and I let her go.
Did what?
I should have at the beginning.
She'll never survive out there.
That isn't our decision.
Are you mad?
You need to let Melena go. You must release her.
You will not get my daughter!
Why did it belong to you? She didn't belong to any man, any place!
There you go with your wicked mouth again.
Witch, isn't that what you called us?
Stay away, you old hag.
You need to let Melena go.
I should have kept her away from me.
You didn't see the things she could do. The things she was capable of. You never believed she could heal people.
You sent her mad.
It was you that had to keep her locked up.
All your mumbo jumbo spirits and magic.
She had a call.
She had a husband and a child. She had a home, him of all.
She was a wanderer.
She was a fragile woman. You manipulated for your own amusement.
You have no idea, do you?
What?
Your wife wasn't some weak young thing. She didn't need your protection because she knew what she was and she knew what she wanted.
What do you mean?
She wanted to leave you.
She didn't leave. She lost her mind. She went out in a blizzard.
She saved her money. She packed her bag. She left you, Bolek.
She disappeared.
She wanted to leave you.
But she's still alive?
Somewhere out there, she's more alive than you'll ever be.
You kept this from me.
She doesn't want to be found, Bolek.
All this time, I thought I could have fixed her. I thought there was some way I could help her.
Life is to be lived, Bolek, not controlled. Now come, let us make it right with Melena. Let's set her free. That's what she needs. Look at her.
You helped to leave her.
It was her will. Unlock the cage, Bolek. It's time to let go. That's it. Melena? Melena! Bolek! What are you doing? Let me out!
I haven't.
Bolek, I won't see you! Let me out!
But Mayor, you don't understand. It's been so long.
I don't have time for this.
It's been nearly 3 weeks now. My wife, my daughter, we have to send out a search party for them.
Yes, but haven't you seen the notices? Last night, we lost a dozen reindeer. A pack of wolves must be migrating, hungry. It practically ripped out their throats, as if we haven't troubles enough.
I command you help me. You was elected mayor for a reason. He was elected mayor to help us all as a community.
Sometimes I dream of a nice little town, cobbled streets instead of mountains. I dream of bustling pavements instead of 5 million square miles of nothingness. But I dream of theaters. I dream of dances. But then I remember what my father told me. This place is in our blood. This place. It's in our blood. But don't you know how dangerous it is out here? One of us could have shot you. And if not that, there are wolves on the prowl too.
I was just on my way home.
Sir, there's something in the bushes.
Keep an eye.
There's nothing here.
Oh, someone hand him a gun. He's going to get himself killed.
So what makes her so special?
Yeah.
And she's been the one eating all our cats.
You told us our children could be fixed.
Now, Wenzel.
Let's get a good look at her.
This is Wenzel. You wanted her in your Laszlo.
My Laszlo? My Laszlo's a fine young man. This is a thing.
You kept your own son! You didn't release him!
Someone shut her up! Now we have a choice, my good people. This creature here is particularly vicious. By far, the most advanced stage we've ever seen. Perhaps it is too late to do anything, and it would be best to put it down.
Yes.
Or perhaps we give Bolek one last chance to administer the treatment he so vehemently advocated for on his own.
Let's see it.
But you practice now, and you can make it swift.
Do it. Do it!
I had a dream too!
What? That I was out there. Out in the wilderness, far beyond our houses. That I was a part of it. That place. Trapping animals, eating birds, supping water from a dirty lake. But then, in my dream, the water clears and I see my reflection. And I think maybe, they are us and we are them. Although, I may have forgotten it, and although the only paths I see are in my dreams and memories. Now, Wenzel, maybe this is part of a natural process. Maybe we need it.
Have you lost your mind too, Bolek? Yeah. You cannot hold divine justice. Get on with it.
Yeah.
They will.